What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan Sean, and today we're going over 5 benefits or just things you should know about the high volume music release strategy. People who've used this are Future, Lil Wayne, Tupac, Russ, Gucci. All of these artists are known for periods when they released a lot of music in a short period of time. Number 1, quantity over quality. I gotta go ahead and bust this myth. So a lot of people think that quantity over quality means that you don't care about your music in terms of high volume strategy, but what this strategy really means is getting good at creating good music really quickly. So if you think about somebody like Lil Wayne, a lot of people who have been in the studio with him said that, man, this dude comes up with great verses really quickly, particularly at his prime. That's what creating and releasing a lot of music does for you. It's a muscle to train. It's something that you have to condition your mind to do, and eventually you can create good music quickly. Number 2, it takes advantage of how attention works. Quick story. I went to an event about 4 years ago and I talked to a few of the artists and got their information because they were cool and I wanted to maybe interview them later on, whatever. One of those artists was Russ. Out of all the artists I checked out, most of them had little to nothing on the internet. Russ, on the other hand, had a whole lot of information up there. He had a whole lot of videos, and I had no idea at that time he was going to be known to be somebody who dropped 11 albums in a short period of time. But because he was good and he had so much content, he kept my attention, and he was the only artist that I even remember out of all those people I checked. I can't even remember the names of the other people. So this is number 2 in a nutshell. I don't have a short attention span. You have a short interesting span. When you get people's attention, it's to your benefit to have as much for them to check out as possible. Because once you have it, if you lose it, they might never circle back to you again. Now, number 3 is experimentation. Plain and simple, a value of creating a lot of music is the fact that you start to try new things. Because you're doing so much of it, you're going to tire of doing the same thing over and over again. You're going to start getting creative and probably find some pockets that you wouldn't have found, at least not as quickly, if you were creating music at a slower pace and releasing at a slower pace, because you're going to want to switch up the sound that other people hear. Number 4, you get to play the lottery. It's like when you buy 20 scratch-off cards as opposed to buying 1 or 2. You don't even know necessarily what song is going to be the hit. Kanye West did not think Gold Digger was going to be a hit. He didn't like that song. Yo Gotti didn't think Down With The DMs was going to be a single for him. But that song took off on its own. At the end of the day, you never know what's a hit until the audience gets a hold of it and you see how they respond to it. Unless you're trying to follow that specific pop formula, you can probably kind of make a hit, but I ain't really trying to speak to those people. I'm speaking to the people who are trying to do something interesting and unique with their art. Number 5, the law of intimacy. The fuck is that? Let's put it this way. Have you ever spent some time with a guy or a girl and you didn't really like them, but then you spent a lot of time with that person and next thing you know, you start feeling them? That's the law of intimacy. The law of intimacy simply states that the longer that you spend with something or someone, the closer you get to it. How that works for the high volume music release strategy is when you're releasing a lot of music and people keep listening to it and keep listening to your content, you have a lot of content, they get more invested in you because over time they start to feel closer to you, especially those artists that express exactly how they think. People feel like they get to know them, they still feel like they're a friend, and that's what makes people show up to concerts. They want to go see this artist that they're invested in. An example of this for me is YouTuber Kane Carter. Love dude's videos. Dude came out with videos constantly and then for the entire 2016, didn't see anything. He didn't drop a video until the end of December 2016. I'm like, yo, where my dude at? Where homie at? Turns out, God bless, he had a really tough year, but my point is, because he was releasing videos so constantly and over years, I got so close and invested in his videos. When he was gone, I'm literally checking throughout a whole year, wondering where this dude is, without him even trying to get my attention. It's the power of being gone, but not forgotten. That's it. You know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.